I have a dream. I have a dream. I have a dream.
wife first. Is he a great trainer? He always get me going. If I'm weak, he'll get me in. He'll tell me I'm weak. You know, he'll tell me you're being soft or something. And then he a brother figure too. He always there for me.
Ah, he won't let me in. Rasheed won't let me into my room.
If I need girl problems for a fact, but what I hate about this dude, is this dude think he could guard me. He think he could lock me up. He always talking mess, talking about I'll finna lock you up. Nah, I don't have like that drift team.
Wow. You
know? I take him one-on-one all the time, you know, wow. Take him straight to the hoop. He wow. can foul me, it's all good. I get an and-one, hey, you know what it is.
Wow.
This is what I hate about Noah Blackwell. First off, he's always talking mess to me like he can really check me, okay? He can't check me. All right. Always talking mess, trying to wrestle me, he's not strong enough, he ain't ready for that. But no, for real talk though, one thing that bothers me about him is that when it comes to the game of basketball, he has a big name in this area and he has a lot of fans. And people talk a lot of mess and hate on him. And he stays level-headed, which is good, but sometimes I want him to get upset and go off for 50 one game. I always tell him when he loses, when his team loses by a couple of points, and he's only had like 15 that game, maybe 20 that game, and he lost by like 4 or 5, I blame it on him. Because if he's the caliber player that he's supposed to be, he's supposed to take care of that. So that's what I hate about him sometimes, that he allows people to talk the mess they do, and he just stays cool. Sometimes I want him to get a little angry and get upset and get after those guys on the court and let people know that he's the real deal. That's one thing I hate about Noah Blackwell. Now, what I like about the kid, man, he's cool, man. He's a good kid. You know, he's humble. I like working out with him. I'm like living with him, man. You know, he's like a little brother. I don't have a little brother, I have a little sister. We're close, but you know, it's cool to have a little brother at hoop, man. And I feel like, you know, it keeps me on my toes, make sure I'm a good role model for him, and make sure he's on his game. You know, I talk mess to him, I straight up with him, and I like that he takes my criticism, because I'm kind of harsh on him. You know, I keep it real. I'm not going to be his best friend all the time. I'm going to tell him what's really good. So, he's funny too, man. This dude's a clown. Being around him, such a clown. He's just a clown. Keeps me laughing, keeps me young, or at least I feel like I'm young. But yeah, man, I love him like a brother, man. Love his family to death, man. Take care of me, man. I look out for him. So that's what I like about him, man. Hopefully, man, he'll do what he needs to do, get a scholarship, and the sky's the limit. Maybe you see him in the NBA one day.
Like this, you toss it to yourself. You get it. You jab. You face up. You jab.
Defender.
You jab.
Right.
Right. Right. You jab again.
Right.
He come up. You jab right there.
Right.
You here. Here.
Oh.
Boom.
Right.
Look at him. Okay. Look at the defender. Drift teams. Straight. Clap. Clap.
Such a great drill. Very realistic and everything.
That's a move. That's a move, not a drill.
The look away game winner. Did I make it? Oh yeah, I made it.
Wait, you made it.
Shout out to that.